Been sitting here tipping back Crown straight, working up the nerve and the words to say, to turn those eyes and that smile my way, no time to waste.
This is a Mustang gelding. He came to me because he sucks to be bridled. He'll set back, he'll throw his head around, hit you in the face if you're not paying attention. He has recently tried biting the owner, I think just for coming into his space. So he's starting to show a lot of aggressive, dominant type behaviors. Another trainer had this horse for a short bit trying to fix his bridling issues. And the technique she was using was less than ideal and, you know, didn't work great for him. And I think it caused a lot of trauma and actually, you know, caused him to go backwards in training. So I'm just working on resetting his brain. Same thing I've been talking about in a lot of my other longer videos is relax and just hang out and chill with your horse. I sent this video to the owner and she was amazed that he was just standing there, head down low, chill and relaxed. So all I'm doing is pulling down on his halter and I have my hand just up by his head and I'm asking him to lower it a little bit and I'm giving a lot of little releases. So release, release. So right in that little few seconds, I probably gave 4 or 5 releases, little mini releases. And then when he holds his head down low, soft, I remove my hand completely. So bridling isn't really the issue. The issue is he doesn't like the top of his head touched, his ears touched. He gets defensive, nervous. He puts his head straight up in the air, making it hard for him to bridle. So I don't have a bridle. I'm not even going to attempt to bridle him yet until he's calm and quiet with me moving my hands around above his head. I want to be able to reach around, touch the other side of his ear, his poll, lower his head, move his head around me wherever I want, touch his ears like I am. So coming up here, he will shoot his head up and he goes straight backwards. I, at that point, stop trying to lower the horse's head because you're not going to win that battle and you're going to cause a bigger fight. So when he goes backwards, I just stick with him. I stick with him and just keep my hand up as high as I can to be safe. If you don't think you can be safe doing this, do not do this, because you put yourself in a very vulnerable position. Being with a nervous horse that has bit, it just can get dangerous. So if you don't feel like you can do this safely, don't do it. So I'm asking him to lower his head. This is his off side. Nobody works on the right side very often. So he's a lot more nervous. He puts his head up. I'm just trying to walk with him, assess the situation, see if he's going to be aggressive or just walk back. So I'm just sticking with him. I'm not getting upset. My body language is calm. When he stops moving his feet, then I'll start asking just a little bit to lower his head. So I gave him a couple releases right there with my body. You can't see. But I wait for him to relax a little bit. And then I brought him right back up into camera view so you can see it better. And I go right back into the same thing with, having him lower his head, touch his ears, and just get him really comfortable hanging out down low. So this is going to be video 1 of 2. I will introduce video 2. I think I'll introduce the bridle with that one and I can show you how it goes hand in hand and how you can work through it with the bridle as well, because bringing a new object into it, he's going to have a lot more anxiety with it because that was the original trigger to begin with. So we'll have to go through everything I'm doing right here with lowering his head with the bridle as well. So I will show that.
Make a move, I better make a move. Somebody